2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the bean? Too early, maybe later, you could show me things.
10 on 3.
Yep.
Anything else for you?
It'll be it, man.
Thank you, bro. 1 mistake that I always make is that I try to move so fast. Like, even when I'm trying to learn something and get a skill, first I was trying to get my real estate license. It didn't happen. The time got over. Then I was like, let me try to do work in insurance and let me see how that goes. I never did the course. Like, I put myself up in situations where I don't need to be at, where I don't need to do. And the reason why I'm saying this again, because you need to control yourself, knowing I want to do something because I genuinely want it. It is very easy to get influenced. Someone can literally make you feel like, oh, what I'm doing is great. How about you come and join me and do the same thing? This is life. People are always out there to get you. People are always out there to get your money and your time. But you are the one that needs to have that in the control, that not everybody can run over me. Not everybody can make me fall into something. I will do what I feel like the desire and the need to accomplish. Will be found, guys, like where you may be confused. Like, you will not always like how I was talking previously. You will not always know what do you really want for yourself. You will not always know what's gonna be the best for yourself, even though you are the only person that can really figure this out. Sometimes it takes time. Good things take time to come into your life. If you want greater and bigger things to happen, you have to be patient. You have to be determined toward your goals. And if you cannot be patient with something, if you cannot give that enough time to learn a skill, to build up a habit, to do something that you are very passionate about doing, just like for me with filming and camera and YouTube, I give myself enough time. I make time to learn about this. I make time so I can do research, what kind of videos are doing well or what I need to focus on as a content creator. That way I can be going up on the scale every single day. This is what this thing is about. It is about you bettering yourself every single day. And this can be with anything. If you are working a job, make sure you like the job, right? If you are working to build your own business, it is about how can I scale this business to the next level. That's the number one thing that needs to be on your mind every single day. Have to start having things private to yourself. One thing I realize, everybody is so quick with telling people their goals, their ambition, what they want to do without realizing it's like a form of energy. When you are just telling people about your goals or this is what I'm going to be doing, you got to realize people can always try to put negative energy towards you. Are just a matter of fact how a lot of people just don't want to see you win. This is what a lot of people don't understand. A lot of people do not understand this, that not everybody wants the best for you. Not everybody wants to see you winning. So why are you just telling anyone what your goal is? You have to keep things like that to yourself and to the people that you trust to share with. That's very important, guys.
My soulmate somewhere out in the world just waiting on me. My chef got a recipe for disaster, baking slowly. My heart feel vacant and lonely.
If you are getting so much information in your head, you won't have to process that into your internal memory. But when there is so much things out there, your brain will be everywhere. That's why even when I watch a content creator on YouTube, when I watch YouTuber, I usually stick with one or two of them and just watch their video. I don't try to I want to figure out about this topic. Now I'm gonna see, okay, let me see what everybody is saying about this one topic. I don't like to do that. I'll rather focus on one person and see their point of view and understand, okay, let me see, do I agree with what they're saying or I don't agree with what they're saying? Because the reason why I'm saying all this, because we live in the social media DNA where you may start feeling like, and you may start comparing your life to other people. You may feel like, well, that person is doing way better than me. I don't have anything going on. I don't know what I'm doing with my life. And this is a completely normal feeling. Why? Because you spend so much time consuming all this dopamine from this, all this TikTok, Instagram, Reels, YouTube. When you are on all this platform, what's gonna happen to your brain is you have gazillions of information to go into your brain every second, like from every reel you watch to every TikTok you've seen. Where is all this information is going in your head? So if you cannot control your mind to be patient and learn things like watching this video right here, I promise you not everybody finishes this long-term video, because it takes time. It takes patience to go and sit down and watch a long-form content. This is why not so many people are good. A lot of people don't like YouTube. A lot of people like Instagram and TikTok, so they can get that fast-form content, chat. That's why they're so obsessed with that.
Hey. Truck to the plane, to the truck to the hotel lobby. Me, I go through underground garages, presidential suite on deposit, elevator up to the room, shower up and then we hit the club. Touchdown, gotta see what's up, area code in my phone. What numbers do I still have? Who do I know from the past? Hit one, she say she got a man. Hit another one, it goes green. Must have changed foes on the team. Remember when you let me in between? That was 2017, all good.
One thing that I do want to say to anyone watching this video is you have to be true to yourself. Sometimes you may do things that you may feel like, is this is going against what I believe in? Is this is something that I should not be doing? Once you be completely true to yourself and be faithful to yourself, you will realize you will have less problem in your life. And I have said this in the previous video too. Most of the problem that is come into our life is created by ourselves. We create the problem. We create the problem and then wonder, oh, why can we not find the solution for it? Or Where am I really messing up? It's kind of hard for me to see what I really need to do. And in any circumstances that you are in life, and you may feel like, I don't know why this is happening to me. Why me? The answer is simple. What I personally believe in, that everything happens for a reason. Everything that is going on in your life happens for a reason, or it has a lesson behind it. There is learning to do with everything. Everything has a learning opportunity that you can get from any circumstances, any people that you had in your previous years of life. When you look at, imagine all the friends that you had in high school, or all the friends you had when you were younger, there is something you can take away from them. Even though you guys may not talk, you may not communicate at all, zero communication, there is always something that you can take out from them and use that for yourself to learn something, to gain a new skill. So that is $15, Bobby. $15.
50.
No, $15.
Yeah, give me three.
You want three more?
Yeah.
Number 33, right?
Yeah, 33. I'll stay with what I got.
5, 10, 15. All right, Bobby. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, buddy.
All right. Good luck now, Bobby.
Run that for me, Shwill. You got to hit 500.
How many times you want me to run this, sir?
One time.
One time. Hit 500, number 10 and number 25.
What are they on? What number is showing on them?
Number 7 is on 7.
No. Huh?
Number 7 is on 7.
No, no, no. 10 and 25.
10 is on 24 and 25 is on 2.
Give me 10 out of the 25.
10 out of 25?
Yeah.
1, 2.
That takes care of those tickets now.
$10. All right, 110. Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Good luck, man.
All right, when does Mega pull again?
Mega
pulls on Friday, isn't it?
Mega 27.
No, when does it pull? The 27th?
Yep.
Which is when?
Today.
Oh, today's Tuesday?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so crazy. Give me a couple quick picks on this. Let's see, before you do it, let me see what I want. Give me three quick picks on the Mega.
Three quick pick on Mega?
Yeah, pick some good ones now.
I got you. Some big money right there.
Right.
$582 million. $6, boss.
I don't need that much.
They gonna take half of the taxes anyway.
I'd be scared to death to win that kind of money.
You got founder to give back to?
Yeah, I'll give some of it back.
Some of them back. Thank you, well, have a good one. Man, $582 million. I don't want that much, Chad. I do not want that much. That's kind of that's a little lot of money. I just want $100 million. I'll be straight. I'll be straight with $100 million, like, or even $1 billion. I'm gonna be straight with $1 billion. But 582. I'm just trolling, Chad. I'm just trolling. Yeah, no, I'm just trolling. What's going on, sir? The hardest part about moving on from someone, and this can be anybody, a family member that passed away or your friend, anything that could have gone in life, right? What I personally believe, how long are you going to worry about something that is not here anymore? And look, don't get this into the wrong way, but what I'm trying to say is, we have one life, and so many people are so stressed about something that was left in the past. And when things like that happen, when something from the past is keep on messing with you, you have to leave that shit. And I know this is very easy to say and hard to do, because people have trauma, people have things they have went through in life. But if you're not gonna move on from things that has already occurred in your previous lifetime, then it's gonna be hard for you to deal with things, guys. It's gonna be very hard to be honest with yourself and find the answers that you're really looking for. Break right now?
Yeah. $2.
No take it?
No. Thank you, lady.
24/7 go 100. 24/7 go 100. Yep. I don't know why they got the short hair. Yeah, there you go, man. $4. You need some gas?
No, I'm not at the gas
pump. All right, thank you, man.
Thank
you. Let's go together. Okay, 7.
Boss
me?
Yeah, please.
They probably won't
handle it.
Thank
you. All right, boss man, how many honey you need, bro?
Nah, just, I don't need none right now.
No honey?
Zero right now.
You said $7 gas?
No, $6 on $2.
$6 on $2, yeah. All right. That's going to be $8.89. Yes, sir. $8.89. What time you get out, Grossman?
I hope 3 o'clock.
3 o'clock?
Yes, sir.
We got one more hour.
If we can get everybody finished, we can get on out the door. If not, 3:30. Oh. What's going on with
straight on, it's taking a little bit right now.
Oh, there we
got
go.
That, bro.
I appreciate it.
Chad, I ain't gonna lie. Like, I only been in the gym for like a month right now. Probably less than a month, but I know at folks here being delusional or what, but everybody coming here telling me, oh, you look big. Like, you look big how you used to look before, or you look taller. Or you look like, you know, you be hitting the chest workout, or like you be working out in the gym. I'm like, bro, this shit is crazy. Like, it's only been a week or two of me being in the gym because I was not consistent with the gym for almost like 7 months straight. I was paying for the membership, but I never went to the gym. But now it's like weird as hell. Like, bro, I just got in the gym like a week or two ago, and people are like already telling me that you look different, you look big, you look like you work on your muscles. Okay, I mean, to me, it is a compliment. Like, it's nothing but a compliment. I really appreciate every single of them, but I'm like, it's been the little things in life that's really like a motivation you can use for motivation. I'm like, well, if people can already see it, I don't know if they're lying or if they're being honest. If they think so, I gotta go more harder. Like, I gotta put more time in the gym. Like, I have to focus on all the things that I'm consuming, all the foods that I'm eating, and make sure I have a healthy, balanced diet. You can always use things as a motivation, Chad. You can always use things as a motivation. Even when people walk in and I talk with them, it's very friendly. Like, you know, there's always something you can get from them, like learn and see what's going on for real. What's up, man?
Yeah. That
K100 menthol?
Yeah.
All right, what else for you?
That's it.
That's it. $4.99. Yeah, boy. $5.39 with tax. You know, them taxes be up.
Huh?
$5.39 with tax. $5.39.
When they went up?
What do you mean when they went up? How much you give you for?
$4. It used to be that damn one.
$4.
$4.40. Then I put them back.
I don't know. But, all right, give me $4.
I can't pay that much for them.
Give me $4. I don't know what's going on.
How much you got?
$4. One, two, man. Three, four. All right, man. Take care now.
Yeah, man. You too, bud.
Bro, I never really got into video games. I'm not going to say I have never played video games. I have played video games like here probably like once or twice in my life. But all that 2K, all that damn, what's that another game that's really popping right now? GTA, all that things. I never really had no opportunity to play video games. And I see a lot of people who are very addicted to playing video games. I just never understand why. But also when I think about it, it is also another form of habit. just like everybody has bad habits, just like how everybody has bad habits, a lot of people are addicted to playing video games. That's what they like to do. So what can I say, bro? If you feel like you're addicted, just like social media, take a break. Go on a detox, take a break, because that's gonna get you right. That's gonna get your mental stability right, fam. It's gonna get you right. So do that, you know, do that. Bro, one thing I'm starting to realize, one thing that I realized so much is how time just flies on so fast. I promise you, when I was younger, right, or any of us, like when we are young, we feel like, bro, I have so much time. There is no need to rush things. Like, I have so much time on this earth. But slowly you're gonna start realizing, damn, I'm already 20 years old, I'm already 30 years old. Like, time is not stopping for nobody. You have to get to the grind. Hey, how you doing, man? All right, man. You been winning some money?
I want $4, but
you want $4? What ticket you had?
Huh?
What ticket you had?
What did I have? I had I forgot,
because
I had some from everywhere, but I know it was the ones I got out of here. But it was one of these.
You
want to
try, what, $5 ticket, ma'am?
I'm going
to
try 5 today.
What, number 32 is good.
Really?
Yes, ma'am. A lot of people been hitting on that number. Ooh, 32.
Give me 32.
All right.
Give me 232.
All right.
And give me 2 number 27.
27, okay.
And that's it.
Wow. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. $14 ticket. There you go, man.
Okay. Thank you. I got the wrong one. Okay.
I like your bracelet. It's pretty nice,
thank
man.
Thank you. Thank yes, you. Man. Ex-boyfriend gave it to me.
Oh, really? That's sweet, man. It's still wearing.
He wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
Take care.
All right. Good luck now, man.
Thank you.
Bro, some people are just sweet. Like, they have that happy energy from them. Like, when a lot of people come here, I can just feel like, okay, this person has positive things going on just by the vibe they give off, just by the energy they interact with. Some people will come here, you'd be like, oh, so how's your day going? But I know, like, a lot of people don't like to talk, but a lot of people, like, they are bots. Yes, yes, no, no, yes. I don't mean to call anybody bots, but yeah, bro, you know what I mean. Like, y'all know what I mean, what I'm talking about. Like, a lot of people don't know what the hell they're doing. Well, neither do I. I'm not saying, like, I have everything figured out. I'm not saying that at all. Like, a lot of times I feel lost. I'm still feeling lost till it's like, I'm still feeling lost while I'm talking right now. I don't know everything that I'm doing. I don't know where I'm going, but I know, like, there is a bigger picture out there. I know I have a vision set for myself. I know the things that I want to accomplish in this life. And the crazy thing is, bro, like, it's gonna be year or two on this YouTube channel, and this I'm not even really gonna be making, like, things will be different, locations will be different, timing will be different, it will be a lot of new people. That's how beautiful this journey is. You just got to embrace it every single day. What's going on, bro? All right,
how you doing?
All right, hitting some big money on this?
No,
nothing. Check it out, right? For $20.
Let me do about 2 number 16.
2 number 16. All right.
And give me 2 2.
2 number 2.
Yeah.
$20, $40. $60 ticket. $20. $40.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Got 4.
The moment I stay here more than an hour, like an hour, it all it takes for the damn start really being cold. Like, that's why y'all see me putting the jacket on, because it's really be getting cold out here, for real. Don't even take too much, but chai, man, it's getting cold out here, fam. But that's why I had to put my jacket back on. And most of the time I do have to, most of the time I do be having to go to the cooler. Now the cooler is crazy, bro. That thing be freaking freezing. Like, that's why in the winter time it's be more cold. Sometime I had to put like, I thought I was tweaking because the camera is running. I was like, wait, I'm not even moving. How the camera is moving? But in the winter time, sometimes I have to put like two jacket on, because you got to realize the temperature inside the cooler needs to be more colder, even though it's winter time. I know this is common sense. I don't know why I'm explaining this, but common sense ain't that common, chat. Common sense is not that common. So this is why I had to say it. But this is my, man, this is my dad jacket, but this thing feels comfortable. Like, this thing feel comfortable than the most jacket that I even got in my closet. I don't know why. Sometimes it's about quality and not quantity. If you focus on, and it's not like the greatest quality ever, it's like how soft the jacket is. And most of you thinking I'm just yapping in this video, it's not really just yapping, it is professional yapping. It is professional yapping. You feel me? But I'm just trolling, bro. I'm just trolling. Like, this is a blog, so what else, man? Come on. Y'all know it.
Fuck evaluation, show me personal funds. It's the pretty boys versus the petty boys. Sold that already, got a whole new set of toys. Shit is so surreal, Drizzy Drake, you better enjoy it. Nothing else bigger than the OVO Letterman boys. Cashmere knits for the nighttime boat rides. Ollie.
So basically, like I was saying earlier, that somebody had gotten a bike and run away from the damn little house right there. A few minutes ago, two cops had came here, like came here looking around for the guy, and they wanted to see the camera. So I had pulled the camera out, and you can see it's a little car and it's a person right there. So he had came inside the store and got to somebody else's property and stole their bike and all kind of things. So things like that don't always happen here. It's a very country small town, but you know, crimes is everywhere. Like, people would do some stupid stuff anywhere, chat, anywhere. But with all that being said, this is all I got for this blog right here. It's gonna take a lot of editing to really get the video like how I really want to. But with that being said, I really appreciate every single of you that watch this whole blog. I really appreciate every single of you. And Missionary Prologue, and now I catch you up with the next video.